Surprised you? Matt Pash was looking pretty good with the slicked back hair, a style I've never really seen on him, but he kind of rocks it, so I was pretty surprised by that.
Excellent. Thank you, judges.
So to start off our evening, to give some words of advice to our contestants tonight, we have a video from former Mr. Norwell winners. Take a look at the screen.
You a story.
Mr. Norwell contestants
and students
of the class
of 2017.
For those of you going to college next year, we'd like to take this time to share a little advice with you.
It's important to use your time productively.
Make sure to put yourself out there, get involved in the dynamic social scene in a healthy way.
Now, I'm gonna teach you how to woo the ladies. Watch this.
Don't waste money on superfluous things.
Generally try to be courteous to your neighbors.
It's important to stay
here. Bottle of whites.
Bottle of red.
Perhaps a bottle of
Welch's non-alcoholic grape juice instead.
You're welcome, Miss Adams.
Never give G up, never left G now. And where G?
I sing a song.
I play a little ping pong.
Now that I think about it, a lot's happened since we were on this stage.
Of this evening, we are going to see all the contestants in their formal wear. with their lovely
escorts.
Thank you.
All right. First up, welcome to the stage,
Mr. Brian Bates and his entourage.
Yeah,
Bubba Whisk?
No, put up. leave.
I mean, normally I tend to go mild, because like, that stuff's still pretty hot. But on those rare days where I'm feeling really risky, I'll go medium.
Mild, medium, or hot?
Definitely hot, because you got a little on the edge.
Mild, medium, or hot?
I like corn.
Mild, medium, or hot?
Medium, because you never know when to get hot.
Teacher, NHS.
Steady
Christian.
It's gotta be Mr. Jacob. Oh, what? What are we doing? What? What is this? What? Mr. Jacobs. Once upon a time, I was a hell of a man.
Deep throat by Cupcake.
Fast car by the Tricky Chapman.
Hey, Moody Basie, please, can we ask you some questions? Brian, what are you doing here? Brian, what's going on with your career right now? Brian, we have some questions. Why are you in Norwell?
Where's Norwell?
Hey, yeah, not Riley.
Definitely Miley Cyrus. She's way more attractive with her brown locks.
Definitely Miley, but Miley from the last song. That was at peak.
Hannah or Miley?
That's Zach and Cody. Seduction.
Aerospace engineering.
What is your dream date?
April 29th, because it's not too hot and it's not too cold, but you need a light jacket.
Wait. What is your dream date?
That would be June 30th, 2004, because that's when the movie came out, Spider-Man 2.
What's your dream girl?
Well, it's a man.
Are you in a relationship right now?
Yeah, actually, it's going really great. I think I'm actually in love. Jared Thorbaugh's just a really hot guy.
Who's your spirit animal?
Well, usually in this case, I would go with any prehistoric dinosaur, such as a Tyrannosaurus Rex, but in this case, I'm going to go with Lupercora.
What's your spirit animal?
Two tickets!
Who's your spirit animal?
Jared Thorbaugh.
That's a pink almond. Patrick Star.
Looks like a pink grain of rice.
Isn't that one of the makeup cleanser things?
Yeah, that is something you use to apply makeup. A peach emoji.
Don't worry, smiling.
Probably the demon face.
What's your high school confession?
Lower blue was me.
What's your high school confession?
Lower gold, girls' bathroom was me.
What's your high school confession?
Oh, I dropped out.
Now, there's only one actor who can play such a national treasure as me, Nick Cage.
Soul Surfer, with both arms.
Because those cats are just fantastic. Well, hopefully someone good, someone highly experienced, Kevin James, Adam Sandler, just to name a few.
Who's your senior crush?
Christian Mudge and Casey Grant together.
Who's your senior crush?
What TV show describes your life? What's your go-to karaoke song?
My go-to karaoke song, the weather goes, it's raining men, hallelujah, it's raining men.
How do you stay in shape? How do you stay in shape?
I am not in shape.
What are some of the downsides to fame?
Autographs like this and doing charity cases like Mr. No.
What's the one that we talk about?
The other competitors.
Tell us a joke.
Be bait, thanks, you can win.
Tell us a joke.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Your dad. Yeah. I'm back. Yeah. Sorry, Berg. Between was so last year. Boom, roasted.
Roast one of your competitors.
Patrick, methinkest thou art a general offense, and every man should beat thee.
Roast one of your competitors.
community, so like 10 approximately.
What is your secret talent? Why are tennis balls fuzzy?
It's a rare fungus, and a lot of times it doesn't actually affect the tennis balls, and those are called baseballs.
You're a dog person or a cat person?
I'd say I'm a dog person. I like mine grilled in a bun with some ketchup.
I'm a cat or dog person.
Cats are evil, dogs all the way.
Welcome to the stage, Ethan Wu.
Ethan's doing really well. Can we get another round of applause?
the other option.
Nothing.
Nothing.
Wait.
That's crazy that you had a job.
We are thinking the same exact thing as you.
Let's go on to our next act.
That was magical.
Next up, we have Jared Thorbon giving a motivational speech.
High school like this, and you know, even though I've been through it all, high school, college, I'm still so nervous to talk in front of you guys. I know you guys are going off to college soon, you know, playing sports, you know, getting ready for the prom, and I just wanted to help you guys out a bit. Back when I was in high school, I was the man. I got to Harvard, Yale, Princeton, Bunker Hill, and Dartmouth, and I went to all five of them. My nickname was Jimmy the Jet. That's awesome. I had three dogs, two of them died, and I never made honor roll once. But I learned one thing from my success. It's never, ever worth it, and that's what I'm here to tell you guys about today. Each and every one of you, I'm sure when you wake up in the morning, you think of school, maybe a girlfriend, boyfriend, aspirations, your dreams. I used to do that too, and that's where I was completely wrong. When you wake up in the morning, you have to think of your couch. The soft cushions, and the bag of potato chips that you left there last night. They're still open. Crunchy, salty. So, ladies and gentlemen, I'm sure you're wondering now, how do you achieve happiness like me? It's called Jared. Got a nice ring to it, huh? Rolls right off the tongue. Jared. Jared is a state of mind. And only once you achieve Jared may you be perfect. I'd like to show you two specimens that I have here. Look at the tall, strapping man on my right. Confident, probably very smart, successful, wealthy. Get off the stage, get out of here. That is exactly what you need to avoid. Think about how stressed he is, about the three homework assignments that he had to do. Unbearable. Now, to my left, specimen number two. Low energy level, wears his hat wrong, probably just got out of bed. You get off the stage, too. That is Jared. Every single one of you can achieve this, but only once you lose all hopes, all dreams, morals, humanity. Yeah, I think that's all. That's all you gotta lose. So go. Why'd you spend $10 to come here? It's a waste. We're all amateurs. Go home. Sit on your couch. Do nothing. Go to sleep. Maybe 12:30 a.m. Wake up at 12:30 p.m. the next day and just repeat it over and over again. Until then, you're not perfect.
Speech.
Needless to say, I was blown away. I was feeling very inspired. post-speech, and I look forward to more talent.
All right, beautiful. Let's welcome to the stage Matt Paschkowski, showing us something important to everyone, how to stay fit. Round of applause, please.
So this is Mr. Norwell, and what a better place should I show just how masculine I am, how I keep this perfect body of mine. Oh yeah. So, every day, first thing you gotta do before you work out is you gotta do a little stretch. First simple exercise, jumping jacks. That's about how many I do. You don't wanna get too tired. You can't overexert yourself. So now next step, you gotta work on your core a little bit. Gotta do that sit-up. Here we go. So by this point, you should be a little winded. Just a little bit. You still have a long workout ahead of you. Now, next step. This is perhaps one of the most difficult exercises to do, but still warm up. Push-ups with claps. So, here we go. Warm-up, get yourself ready. So now some days you do cardio. I normally run down my driveway. That normally takes me 30 minutes, an hour is a good target for all of you. But today I think we're gonna show off some weightlifting. So if I have my weight spot out. So don't let these deceive you. These are hundreds of ounces right here. I don't know. I didn't actually practice this much. Okay. There we go. Okay. So, you might not get it the first try. And unlike what Jared said, you don't give up. I'm gonna give this one a second try. Okay. This is fine. Everything is fine. Okay. One last try. I got it off the ground! No. Wait, no, I knew that was gonna happen. Yeah, I knew that was gonna happen. So that right there, that was a really difficult workout. Make sure to work up to that. You can't go straight to that much. So I thank you, and this has been How to Stay Fit.
I'm sweating just watching him work out. I know, Mr. Lantier learned everything he knows. Next up, please give a warm welcome to Mr. Chris O'Brien performing an Irish tune.
Not now. For tonight, I will be doing a screw review. Student government said this has to be short, so let's make it short. Slaves, come! Thank you. Than what they wanted me to do, those fascists. We're gonna be doing A-U-N-A! Let's find some hands! Ah, yes, the fat man over there, yes.
Just one way, put your pink or jam
hand. That's a very good question, Jonathan, very good indeed. I do have to say, though, that there was some unfortunate events that happened to JFK. He was assassinated, unfortunately. However, guess what? You wanna know something that you don't know? Guess what? There were two snipers! I've seen some hands. Yes, you're the fat man again.
What's your favorite beverage?
That's obviously a terrible answer. What question, obviously. To keep it late on drinks, we'll be going for my worst. That's gotta be tap water! Because the government puts fluoride in my tap water! I will drink Mountain Dew! Alright, let's look for another question. I asked the man with crippling depression.
You suck!
You know what? We're gonna do something really cool. We're gonna bring our best friend, Jimmy Diggins, up here to do a dab! Let's give it up for Jimmy! For the past 18 years, I've been really lonely, actually. I guess the point I'm trying to say is I really need a girlfriend.
Speculation. God bless America. Capitalism is awesome. Anyway, today I'm here to tell you a little bit about our movement, the Church of Jennings. Ours is a movement dedicated to the betterment of mankind through faith, kindness, and love for everyone. Except for the people who don't agree with us. I hate them. You know, take the liberal media, for example. Now, Ed Sheeran and Ryan Gosling are trying to make your kids into devil-worshipping murderers who probably order onions in their home fries at a stab. Obamacare is the mathematical equivalent of running on a treadmill for 24 hours in sandpaper underwear while listening to the Chainsmokers on repeat. soundtracks are awesome. George Bush is probably the best president we've ever had. Anyway, back to the point. Unity is important. A sense of belonging is important. And I can show you the way. Take Kevin here, for example. Kevin is a handsome man, a family man, probably owns a large purebred dog. Now, Kevin, why are you here today?
I'm blind.
Well, Kevin, I have the solution to your dilemma. Favor and read the number on this little slip. That's right. That's 7-2. Good job, Kevin. You see, that right there is the power of our movement. That right there is the power of yours truly. Because, you see, our movement is more than just a simple church. And I am more than just a man. I'm a god.
Faith was strong, but you needed proof. You
sunbathing all new. Her beauty and the moonlight overthrew you. Now she tied you to a kitchen chair. She broke your throne and she cut your hair. And from your lips she drew the hallelujah. This floor, you know, I used to live alone before I knew you. And I've seen you fly on that marble arch. Love is not a victory march. It's a cold and it's a broken hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
Yeah. booty, 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 thrust your booty, west. Booty, thrust your booty, ah, big, 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 big.
Simply of what came first was the meteor that made sure that all the dinosaurs were dead.
Please welcome Mr. Chris O'Brien.
rhinoceros. That's all.
Smart and also extremely athletic. Get the hell out of here.
We have 16 weeks. I can't do boxing.
Sorry.
This is too tough.
Line, what is your dream date?
Take two.
You gotta live on the edge. You gotta live on the edge.
What's your dream girl?
Well, it's a man.
Jesus.
If you have the chance to change your fit, would you?
Because it looks like...
What? What's your dress impression?
Dark Vader.
Dark? Dark.
What's your dress impression?
Dark Vader.
It's Darth.
Darth Vader.
Are you gonna do it?
Goes to Troy.